but problem. Write algorithm and flowchart to add two numbers. So yesterday we have seen the algorithm. Now we have to convert this algorithm into a graphical representation. That is nothing but flowchart. So how the algorithm we have written? What is step one? Step one is always start. I am writing the algorithm. Same what I have written yesterday, I am writing once again. What is step two? So what is the title of the problem? Write algorithm and flowchart to add how many numbers? Two numbers. So we need to input two numbers. So that input I am writing as read A, comma B. I need two numbers. Now what is the question? We need to add. Then I need to add two numbers and store in C. So what is the next step? Third step is C is equal to A plus B. This is the calculation part. This is the start symbol. Start. What are the inputs required for solving our problem? What is the problem to be solved? Calculation part. Now fourth. Now, C contains addition of two numbers, it is in C. Now, I have to display this onto the monitor. So, I can use print. Print C. Yesterday, I have written display. Here, I am using print. You can also use write. It is only for user understanding purpose. It is only for our understanding purpose. So, it is not compulsory that you have to use print only, or you have to use display only, or you have to use write only. It is our understanding. What is the next step? Next step is stop. So same what I have written the step yesterday, it is same step. Start, stop. Start will be always first statement, stop will be always last statement. So these are the inputs, this is the calculation, this is the output. So yesterday I did display. Here I am using print. Now I will write the flowchart. Now, start. Start symbol. What is the start symbol? Start symbol is oval. First step is oval. What is the second step? Read A, comma B. Reading means it is input. Here instead of read, you can also write as input. Input A, comma B. Here for print, you can use output C. It's only for our understanding purpose. So read. Read means input. So what is the next step? Next step is read. Read A, comma B. See here, I have used the arrow. That means the flow is coming from this symbol to this, in this direction. This is the arrow. So arrow uses to represent the flow of the problem. Next, C is equal to A plus B. This is the calculation part. What is the symbol used for calculation part? It is the rectangle symbol. C is equal to A plus B. Now, print C. Print means it is the output statement. What is the symbol used for output? It is a parallelogram. Print C. Next, what is the last statement? Last statement is stop. What is the symbol used for stop? Again, oval. So here you can see that the arrow indicates the flow of the process. From start, we will come to the next step. Next step is input A, comma B. Next, after getting the values, two values, we are adding the two numbers and storing in C. After completing this calculation part, we want to display it onto the output screen. See the arrow. This arrow indicates the flow of the problem. Arrow indicates the flow of the problem. Now this is A, this is B. This is the output C. So what are the names I had used here? A I had used, B I had used, C I used. This is called as tracing. Tracing the problem, whether our algorithm or flowchart, whether it performs what is the problem to be solved, whether we are getting the correct solution or not. Now say that it is 5 and it is 3. A is 5, B is 3. Now what is the calculation? C is equal to A plus B, 5 plus 3. I am storing in C. What is the C value now? 8. So display C. Then stop. So this is the output. This is the output. So this is the algorithm, flowchart. This is the tracing, whether we are getting the correct value, correct output or not for different values of A and B. Like if I take A is equal to 8, B is equal to 2, C is equal to A plus B. 8 plus 2 I am storing in C. So what is 8 plus 2? 8 plus 2 is stored in C. Then I am displaying C value. So this is the output. This is the output. So this is about algorithm, flowchart and trace. In this, any doubt for anybody? Any doubt? Students, are you able to understand?
Yes, sir.